kids, I'm glad you're here today. We have an extra special episode of Kids in the Word. We have an important holiday coming up. Do you know which one it is? That's right. It's Memorial Day, a day where we remember and honor all those who have fought for our freedom in America. Plus, we get to see Uncle Vito today. You remember him, right? Vinny's great uncle? We invited him back to talk to you today, and well, he's pretty excited. But before we go see Uncle Vito, let's take a second to remember our memory verse, Ephesians 6:10, be strong in the Lord. Have fun with Uncle Vito and the others, and I'll see you guys when you get back.
Hey, yo, Uncle Vito, how you doing today?
Hello, Vinny. Hello, Rosie. I'm doing good, really good.
How you do, whippersnappers?
We're great, Mr. Vito. We heard there was something special you wanted to share with us today.
Yeah, there sure is. I've been reading the Bible that you guys gave me, and I gotta tell you, I'm learning so much.
That's great, Uncle Vito. What you been learning about?
Everything. How much God loves me. Can you believe that, man? He loves me. I'm learning about the amazing miracles that Jesus did. I'm learning about people that had phenomenal God-given strength, and so much more. But there is one thing I read about this week that I had to read a few times. It was so nice to read.
What was that, Mr. Vito?
Well, let's see. It's 2 Samuel 23, 13-17. David was in the stronghold, and then Philistines, they were camped around him and his men, and he was completely surrounded. He was thirsty, so thirsty. Then three of his brave soldiers, they broke through the enemy lines just to get him some fresh water from the well that he loved. Can you imagine someone being willing to risk their life to save yours? I gotta say, it really touched me. Reminded me of my days in the war.
You served in the war, Uncle Vito? Wow, I really do have a lot to learn.
I did. I served in the Vietnam War. It's not something I talk about often, but this scripture reminded me of my buddy Louie. We were pretty good friends in that time, and I sure wish I had kept in touch with him more. He played such a big part in my life.
What about the story reminded you of Leo, Mr. Vito?
Well, there were so many times that Louie put me first. He really lived to love like Jesus loves, you know? I wish I had understood that more at the time, but one time in particular reminded me of this. Louie and I had been out running drills, and it began to downpour rain. We got stuck for hours. Finally, the rain let up enough we could escape from the area, get back to base. That's when I realized I was really stuck. My foot was caught deep in the mud. We heard people coming. We didn't know who they were, but we were scared. That was for sure. I tried to get Louie to go on without me. Told him I'd lie low. He could maybe come back for me later. But Louie, man, he refused to leave me. He preferred me. He went, he got a stick, and he dug me out. Took a lot of guts, but man, was I grateful that day. And every day since, he risked his own life for me. Louie and I got separated from each other after that. Split into two different base camps. Wish I had tried harder to find him again after that, after we got out. He was so strong, not just physically, but mentally and emotionally, and
And it sounds like he was strong in the Lord and had on all the right armor, including the armor of God.
Hey, Uncle Vito, if you remember Louie's last name, I might be able to help you track him down. Would you be interested in that?
Would I? Of course. I'm not sure what I'd say to him after all this time, though.
You could tell him how thankful you are and that you know Jesus, too.
And I'm sure if you ask God to help you find the right words, he would.
That's a great idea, Rosie. You're a smart girl, a real smart girl.
In the meantime, would you mind sharing some more stories with us, Mr. Vito? I think me and Vinny have a lot to learn from the experiences God's brought you through.
It's been a while since anyone asked me about them. But for you kids, sure. What'd you like to hear?
Wasn't it great hearing about Louie from Uncle Vito? It was nice for us to hear, and I'm sure it was nice for Uncle Vito to talk about. Sometimes one of the easiest ways we can choose to honor someone is by choosing to listen to them. Really listen, because they have a lot to teach us. Maybe you kids have someone you can reach out to tell you their life stories, like Rosie and Vinny did with Uncle Vito. Maybe a grandma or a grandpa, or an aunt or an uncle, or maybe even a teacher or a pastor. And while they're sharing their stories with you, you can share your memory verse with them. Ephesians 6:10, be strong in the Lord. Have a great weekend, and take some time to thank the Lord for the brave men and women who gave up their lives so that we could be free. See you next week.